What's up, guys? Dr. Lee, the persistence coach, coming to you this morning. And I just wanted to hop in and share a quick thought that I have with you today. And that is, from our believers out there, that is, we must move our feet, right, to give God something to bless. So, you know, I think, just because considering everything that's going on right now, a lot of people are sitting on their hands. They don't know what to do. They don't know how to do it. The routines are off, and it seems very difficult to continue to make momentum right now. And so I want to encourage you that, you know, you can be blessed even in this moment when you are moving your feet and you are sowing. So, and by sowing, I mean you are actively taking action toward some result, something that you want to bring about in your life. And, you know, many of us can get discouraged by time, circumstances, situations. You know, this pandemic has been very discouraging for a lot of people. It's had ripple effects in more ways than one, right? But what I want to encourage you is that if you are able-bodied, if you have hands, you have a feet, you have a phone, you have internet, you have email, right? You have social media. All of these things you can use in a way to help you continue to move forward towards your vision, your dream, your goal, your aspiration. So instead of getting caught in completely thinking about what isn't working, what's been taken from you, what you've lost. Instead of focusing on that, I would encourage you to move past that in your mind. Move past that in your mind and see how you're going to be coming out of this. See what you want to be coming out of this. See how you can actually use this time for your advantage in some way, shape, or form concerning something that you want to do in your life. Compare this time right now to how it was before and look at some advantages that you have. Yes, things you may have lost, things you may have, you're not doing what you used to do. You may have lost access to some things, but you still have things. What do you have? What can you use? What advantage do you have right now? What opportunity has presented itself right now? How can you capitalize on what's going on right now? That's what I want to encourage you to overcome your mind with. Okay, there's a verse in the Bible where it talks about meditating on good things. And I think it is so germane right to right now in this place and time. There's so many aspects of our life that aren't going well. There's so many aspects of our life where things have been taken away. There's so many aspects where we can say, hey, this time sucks. We're going through a pandemic, an economic recession. We can focus on what is not good. But my encouragement is to focus on what is good, what is still good, right? And it can be some basic things that a lot of people take for granted, but you know, they are blessings still, right? If you have a mind where you can think and be creative, you have limbs that you can use, eyes where you can see, ears where you can hear, you are still able-bodied. Those are some basics, right? And everybody doesn't have those. Right, so you can begin with some of the basics, and then out from there, you can look at other things that are good. And this is a way for you to shift your mindset and focus on opportunity, focus on the goodness, right? The goodness of God, the things that are good, focus on those. And then in that mindset, right, in that mindset of gratitude, that mindset of thanksgiving, from that space, now you have the opportunity, right, to think about opportunity, to think about positive outcomes, to think about moving toward your dream, right? But the beginning of it is getting out of, hey, what's not working, and getting into what can I make work? What can I do right now? I do understand that I can't do XYZ, but what can I do? So by shifting your mindset to thinking about what can you do, now that allows you to use your brain, your facilities, and your mind now to problem solve, right? And to capitalize. And so that's what I'm talking about. So, you know, I hope this blessed you today. But at the end of the day, if you want to be blessed, and this is what I'm saying, you want to be blessed, you want to have this, you want to have that, you want to have success. At the end of the day, you're going to reap what you sow. So you have to sow into that. You have to move your feet so that God has something to bless. If you're sitting and not moving, there's nothing to bless. There's no activity to bless. There's new opportunities. There's no opportunities now to bless. God's not a genie, right? He's given us a lot of power, right? We have hands and feet and a mouth and a mouthpiece. And we have things that we can do. So at the end of the day, if we want to be blessed, we have to do the things. We have to do things to bring those to us, right? To attract that to us, to then come in, to be aligned, right, with how God sees us. And now, right, because our mind is there and our actions are there, now we can get blessings to flow for us, God. So I just, I'm just praying for everyone. I'm hoping that, I can encourage you today to look at the situation a little different. Look at what you can do. Look at what opportunities you have. Look at what is going well. Look at what you can be thankful for. And then start moving your feet in that mindset. And you can make momentum during this time. All right, guys. I've been really kind of, focusing on offers for this time, because I have so many, there's many facets of my business that I think folks could really benefit from right now. And so Persist Institute is what I've really been encouraging folks to join. This is an online mastermind where you are able to get training every month with me and go through modules that are going to help you set up everything from goal setting to time management to clarity, all of these things where people can get stuck in times from, right? I want you guys to go and check out Persist Institute. Just check out persistinstitute.com. I'm going to put a link. If you tap on the title of this video, there's going to be a link right in there. You can link right there to opt in and get some free training on clarity and how clarity, bringing clarity to your life of what you want to do, how that can be the stepping stone for momentum, right? So clarity, momentum. It could be the catalyst. Sorry. So up above, click the link, hop into the free training. It's a video training, completely free, that I've put together for you guys. And at the end of that training, you're going to get the opportunity to learn more about Persist Institute. And if it's right for you, I would encourage you to join. All right, guys, God bless, Godspeed. Remember, the folks that are going to make momentum during this time, the folks that are moving, the folks that are taking action, those are the folks going to come out better positioned to capitalize, once this pandemic and all this craziness is over, because we will get through this. The question is going to be, are you going to be a better person, or you're going to be in a better place because of it? All right, guys, God bless, Godspeed. Keep pressing.